Diabetes. Diabetes is a chronic disease in which blood sugar is not processed correctly. Insulin is a hormone designed to control the levels of blood sugar in your body. Blood sugars can become too high if you do not produce enough insulin or if insulin does not work properly. There are different types of diabetes. Type 1 diabetes occurs when the body stops making insulin. About 5 to 10% of people with diabetes have type 1, and it is always treated with insulin. About 90% of people with diabetes have type 2, and it usually affects adults. Type 2 diabetes occurs when insulin does not work well, causing blood sugar levels to rise. Gestational diabetes is a temporary condition that occurs in pregnancy. If you experience gestational diabetes, you have a higher risk of type 2 diabetes and cardiovascular disease and should continue to follow up with your doctor. Prediabetes is a condition in which blood sugars are higher than normal, but not high enough to fit the criteria for diabetes. Nearly half of the people affected with prediabetes will develop diabetes at some point in their lives. Signs and symptoms can include the following: unusual thirst, frequent urination, weight change, gain or loss, extreme fatigue or lack of energy, blurred vision, frequent or recurring infections, cuts and bruises that are slow to heal, tingling or numbness in the hands or feet, trouble getting or maintaining an erection. If you have any of these symptoms, it is important to contact your healthcare provider right away. It is important to recognize that many people who have type 2 diabetes have no symptoms. What are some of the risk factors for type 2 diabetes? Anyone over the age of 40 should be tested for diabetes every 3 years. Anyone who has one or more risk factors should be tested more frequently. Having a parent, brother, or sister with diabetes, if you are of Aboriginal, Hispanic, South Asian, Asian, or African descent, having been diagnosed with prediabetes, impaired glucose tolerance, or impaired fasting glucose, having high blood pressure, having high cholesterol or other fats in the blood, being overweight, especially if that weight is mostly carried around the tummy, having been diagnosed with obstructive sleep apnea, having been prescribed glucocorticoid medication by a doctor, if you were diagnosed with gestational diabetes. Diabetes can lead to serious complications and premature death, but those who have diabetes can take steps to control the disease and lower the risk of complications. Heart and blood vessel disease, nerve damage, neuropathy, kidney damage, nephropathy, eye damage, retinopathy. Education. Diabetes education is an important first step. All people with diabetes need to be informed about their condition. Diabetes education is free. Physical activity. Aim for 30 minutes of moderate to vigorous activity a day. Nutrition. What, when, and how much you eat all play an important role in regulating blood glucose levels. Weight management. Maintaining a healthy weight is especially important in the management of type 2 diabetes. Medication. Type 1 diabetes is always treated with insulin. Type 2 diabetes is managed through physical activity, meal planning, medications, and/or insulin to assist your body in controlling blood glucose more effectively. Lifestyle management. Learning to reduce stress levels in day-to-day life can help people with diabetes better manage their disease. Say goodbye to guilt and consider yourself a step ahead now that you know more about how to control this disease. Blood pressure. High blood pressure can lead to eye disease, heart disease, stroke, and kidney disease, so people with diabetes should try to maintain a blood pressure level at or below 130 over 80. To do this, you may need to change your eating and physical activity habits and/or take medication. For more information, please visit our website.